So this is going to be a session on measurement system analysis. Is that my data collected is free from errors or not, right? So you will be able to better understand. And one particular type I will be covering, maybe a few more approaches are there, like attribute agreement analysis and CAPA analysis. That will be taught to you after this session. So in this particular session, we will understand the measurement system analysis terminology. And we call them bias, linearity, and stability, right? What are these? And then the repeatability and reproducibility, we'll also understand. And then we have a tool called gauge R&R, gauge repeatability and gauge reproducibility, that will help you to measure the measurement error, right? And we will understand that also with some good examples. So quick view of the MSA terminologies. First of all, measurement system. When I say measurement system, it means, you know, the gauge, the appraiser who is involved, the part that is getting measured, the operational definition, the environment, all these things are responsible for, you know, the measurement error. So that is why we call it measurement system analysis. It is not measuring equipment analysis, it is measurement system analysis. So any problem, you should be able to understand it is because of the system. So any one of the component of your system could be a source of the problem, right? So bias, sometimes we call it accuracy, right? When the bias is zero, then you are fully accurate. When there is a bias, then you have started becoming inaccurate. So bias is basically the difference between the average of the measured value and the true value. And stability is nothing but how is your bias over a period of time. That means I have a measuring gauge. I use it today, I use it tomorrow, I use it next week, I use it next month. Is that the bias remains same over a period of time? Because my project is going to be for 6 months. So that means I will be using the measuring gauge for about 6 months. Can I get the bias, the same bias throughout the project duration? That is called stability. And then linearity. I will use a measuring gauge to measure different dimensions, right? The weight may vary from 50 kilogram to 200 kilogram. The dimension may vary from 50 mm to 500 mm. The current can vary from 5 ampere to 20 amperes. It all depends. So the range of measurement can be shorter or can be longer. Is that my bias is same over the entire range of the measurement? That is called linearity. So only when you have stable, linear, and an accurate measurement system, you can keep the measurement error under your control. And similarly, there is one more terminology called resolution, which is nothing but the minimum reading your measuring gauge is capable of providing you. And we'll see that. And then repeatability. If you ask an appraiser or your quality inspector to make repeat readings, repeat reading in the sense same product, same part, you want him to measure multiple times. If he can give consistent readings, even when he measures the same part multiple times, then he is considered to be repeatable. However, if the readings are going to be different each time he measures the same part, then he is considered to have a repeatability error. Similarly, reproducibility error. Same part, but I am measuring and I am saying that it is 101 mm. And same part, I want you to measure. Now you are telling me 102 mm. And now there is a disagreement between you and me. That is called reproducibility error. Nothing but the variation between the appraiser. Whatever reading produced by one appraiser, the other appraiser is not able to produce. That means the system is considered to have reproducibility error. So we'll understand each and everything in detail one by one. First of all, any reading you collect, any data you collect, it will have variation. Am I right? For example, 100 mm dimension, when you measure, you may mark it as 100.05. So that 0.05, 100 is the true value, but 0.05 is the variation. That 0.05 may be because of the variation in the process itself. If it is from the variation from the process itself, we want to control it. But sometimes what will happen, your measurement system may measure 100 mm as wrongly 100.05 or something. And now in this, that way, your measurement system can also bring variation. So any variation or any variation generally comprise of two component. One is process variation, another one is measurement variation. Reducing process variation is our job, is our Six Sigma project. You can do that job properly when your measurement variation is under control, right? So the aim of Six Sigma is to reduce the process variation. Measurement system analysis helps in reducing the measurement error, because when I reduce the measurement error, my focus can, I can have a better focus in reducing the process variation. So doing a project or reducing variation is like, doing a project and making it successful. You can correlate it with driving a car at 100 kilometer speed to reach the destination. When you want to reach the destination by driving your car at an 100 kilometer speed, it is very important you continuously see the road and drive the car, right? Your focus should be on the road. Now you drive the car, reach the destination on time. Same way when you are doing a Six Sigma project, your focus should be on the problem. What is your problem? Process variation. So if you are not able to focus on the process variation, you can't reach the destination. It is something like, if you can't keep your focus on the road, do you think you will still reach the destination on time? Sometimes you may reach the destination delayed, or sometimes you may not even reach the destination, right? Same way, if you are not able to see the process variation properly, you will not be able to make your project a successful one. And that is why it becomes very important. You need to understand measurement variation prior to understanding the process variation. Because if you control the measurement variation, it will help you to focus properly, focus fully on the process variation. It is something like putting a wiper when it is raining, isn't it? Why do you put the wiper? It will wipe out the water droplet, and thereby again you can gain your focus on the road. Same way, when you use the measurement system analysis, you conduct the gauge R&R study, it will wipe out all the measurement error so that you will be able to focus properly on the problem. And what is our problem? Process variation is the problem. So measurement system analysis ensures Six Sigma team focus accurately on the problem, that is process variation, and ensure improvement efforts are put efficiently to reduce the process variation, right? So you can see better and understand better the process conditions, with the MSA. So always it is important to conduct a measurement system analysis study and make sure your measurement errors are reduced to the required level. We always say the requirement is measurement error should be less than 10%. See that is happening, and so that you can see and understand the process conditions better. So coming to the variation, there are two types: process variation